What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Now, the Detroit Lions this season have had their ups and their downs. They've had their great moments and their not so great moments, but I think any Lions fan, if you were to ask them, would tell you that this Lions team, this 2020 Lions roster and organization, have a couple key flaws that are really holding this team back from being a true competitor and, you know, holding this team back from really being competitive in the NFC conference. Now, although that opinion may be unanimous amongst Lions fans, the reasoning behind it and the actual problem in the organization is not so unanimously decided upon. You know, some fans blame Matt Stafford, some fans blame his weapons, some fans blame the defense and the coaching, and some fans blame Bob Quinn, and there are other factors and other opinions out there for why the Lions aren't as good as they should be and what is holding the Lions back from being great. Now, in today's video, I wanted to go over this, kind of talk about it, go over some of the major arguments about why this Lions team was bad, and then give you my personal opinion on what the problem is in Detroit and whether or not it is fixable both for the remainder of the 2020 season as well as future seasons, the 2021, 2022, and beyond. However, before we do get into the video, if you are new to the channel and are enjoying this Detroit Lions content, please consider liking the videos and subscribing to the channel. It only takes 2 seconds out of your day to do so, and it helps the channel out more than you could know. So if you could do that, just take those 2 seconds to like and subscribe. I'd be greatly appreciative for it. But without any further ado, let's get into talking about these problems the Detroit Lions are facing this season and whether or not they are fixable by the end of the season and for the future. Now, of course, there is no one single thing that anybody can point to and say that that is the main and the single problem the Lions organization is facing this season. Obviously, there's no one thing you can point to and say that is the only problem this team faces. This team has a lot of problems and this team has a lot of issues that they need to work out before the end of the season, and they have to figure it out pretty quickly if Matt Patricia wants to be here next season. Now, the big argument that I hear from a lot of Lions fans is that Matt Stafford is the problem. He can't win games. He can't win playoff games. He's never done it. He's not the quarterback. We should just move on. And a lot of people think that Matt Stafford is the problem in Detroit. Now, I don't necessarily agree with this. Now, Matt Stafford in the 2020 season has a 63.7% completion percentage, which is 27th in the NFL. So not a great completion percentage by Matt Stafford, but that's not solely on him. And we'll get into that in just a moment. Matt Stafford has 2,403 passing yards on the season, which is 11th in the NFL. He has 17 touchdowns on the NFL season, which is 11th in the league. And he only has 7 interceptions, which is 10th in the NFL. So, I mean, Matt Stafford, looking at his stats, isn't really a bad quarterback. His completion percentage is much lower than you'd like to see, but he's 11th in passing yards, 11th in passing touchdowns, and 10th in interceptions. Like, he is not having a bad season. He is a borderline top 10 quarterback statistically right now. And yes, has Matt Stafford made his poor choices? Has Matt Stafford thrown some dumb passes, thrown some dumb interceptions, called, you know, ran some dumb plays? Has he made his mistakes and, you know, thrown some poor footballs? Absolutely. Matt Stafford has been far from perfect this season. He's even been far from what we saw from him last season. But Matt Stafford is not the problem. Matt Stafford this season has made his mistakes for sure. He's made his bad decisions. He's made his bad plays. I mean, he's overthrown. He's underthrown. He's not thrown the perfect football every time. But Matt Stafford has also won 3 game-winning drives for the Detroit Lions this season. 1 in Arizona, 1 in Atlanta, and 1 last week versus the Washington football team. Matt Stafford is not the problem in Detroit. Has he been perfect? Absolutely not. Are there things that he needs to improve on? And are there things in his game, are there pieces of his game that I would love to see him improve upon this season from week to week? Absolutely. But Matt Stafford is far from the problem in Detroit. He is one of our best players. He is our captain. He is our quarterback. And he is probably the best player on the team. And he is the most important player on this team. Matt Stafford is not the problem. And if you think Matt Stafford is the problem, and you think the Lions' only issue right now is they don't have the right quarterback to compete, you're just flat out wrong. I'm sorry, I'm not calling you stupid, but if you think Matt Stafford is the problem in Detroit, and that if we were to bring in Trevor Lawrence on this exact roster and with this exact coaching staff, and we would be a playoff contender or even a Super Bowl contender, you are just flat out wrong. And I don't mean to be negative, but I mean, come on. Matt Stafford is not the problem. He is not the issue in Detroit. He's just not. It's not the case. Now, another big argument for the Detroit Lions' problems this season have been the weapons surrounding Matt Stafford. Now, the Detroit Lions have a bottom 10 running game in the NFL. They haven't run the ball super efficiently this year, and they really haven't committed to the run enough to see what our rookie in DeAndre Swift is truly capable of, except with the exception of really last week and week 6. Our wide receivers have the second most drops in the NFL with 23 on the season, only behind the Dallas Cowboys, and they actually lead the NFL with a 7.1 drop percentage. So 7.1% of Matt Stafford's passes are dropped by his wide receivers. Not broken up, not, you know, tight coverage, and it wasn't a completed pass. Like, these guys are open and they flat out drop the ball. So, you know, looking at Matt Stafford's completion percentage, now add that 7% on if they are wide receivers aren't dropping easy passes, and that goes all the way up to a 70.8% completion percentage. And obviously, you know, you're not going to catch everything, but, you know, if you even half that, right? If the Lions even drop half the passes, if they catch half the passes that they dropped this season, Matt Stafford's completion percentage still skyrockets to about a 67, 68% completion percentage, and it looks a lot better, and likely he has more passing yards, more passing touchdowns on the season. So, I mean, so the wide receivers and the running game, and really, you know, just the weapons around Matt Stafford haven't been great for him this season. Now, again, just like Matt Stafford, they've all made mistakes, but they've all also made their plays. I mean, we've seen Kenny Galladay have an amazing game. We've seen Marvin Jones have a great game. We've seen Marvin Hall and TJ Hockenson and DeAndre Swift have great games. We've seen this offensive line play very well before, but, you know, they're inconsistent. They haven't played consistently enough, and yes, they've made their mistakes, but just like Matt Stafford, this offense and the players themselves on the offense are not the biggest reason to why this team is struggling right now, and it is not the biggest problem that needs to be fixed in Detroit. In regards to the players on the offense and both Matt Stafford and the weapons, both of them have made mistakes, as I've said. Both, you know, the wide receivers have dropped open passes. Matt Stafford has overthrown his wide receivers and thrown some pretty poor footballs in his, you know, in the 2020 season. But overall, the offense and the players on the offense are not the major problem. And yes, the offense can be fixed. Matt Stafford can make better decisions. The wide receivers can look the ball in more and make sure they secure the catch before they turn upfield. But overall, this offense is not the problem in Detroit. It has its flaws, it has its issues for sure, but the offense is not the problem in Detroit, and it should not be what Lions fans look at when they want something to blame for why the Lions lose or for why the Lions are losing football games. You know, if the offense isn't the problem, then maybe the defense is the problem, right? Maybe, you know, the defense, Matt Patricia's defense isn't playing well, it's giving up too many points, it's not doing great. You know, maybe that's the reason the Lions are so poor. And that is definitely a case. That is definitely the case, in fact. I mean, Matt Patricia's defense has been pretty bad in Detroit for all 3 years, you know, especially the past two, last year and this year. The Lions are 32nd in scoring defense this year, and they're not much better when it comes to yards allowed. Like, this defense can't stop anything. This defense couldn't stop me if I walked on the field. Like, I would be able to break a tackle from Will Harris at this point. Like, it's that bad. As, like, the Lions can't tackle, they can't really wrap up, they can't get a good pass rush. Like, they just aren't a very good defense. They're giving up way too many points, they're giving up way too many yards, way too many third downs, and, like, it's just embarrassing at this point as a Lions fan to watch this defense go out on the field just to embarrass themselves over and over and over again. You know, the defense has allowed 4 double-digit comebacks this season. In both week one against the Bears, they did it. Week 2 against the Packers, they did it. Week 4 against the Saints, they did it. And last week versus the football team, they did it again, where they were up by 10, 14, 20, 23 points on the season, on the game even. And, you know, they just get relaxed. They back off. They play, you know, less coverage. They, you know, get a little bit lax. They get a little bit less aggressive. And all of a sudden, you know, you're up 24-3. And then you look up 10 minutes later, and all of a sudden it's 24-24. And you're like, well, what the heck just happened? Like, how did they just come back on us that quickly? And yes, a part of that has to do with the defense. Part of it has to do with the defensive talent. And some of it has to do with the coaching as well. Now, the defense is obviously a big problem, and it is obviously the biggest problem for this Lions team. I mean, you cannot expect to be a good football team with the worst scoring defense in the NFL, and you can't expect to be a good football team if your defense isn't playing very well. And while some of that does come down to the players themselves, a lot of it has to do with the coaching, which is the next major flaw that I have critiqued many times, and many other fans have a strong, not hatred, but a strong, I guess, dislike of how our defense is being ran. starting with Matt Patricia himself, the defensive guru that came over from the Patriots and was supposed to take us over the edge. He was not brought here to rebuild this team. He was brought here to take us from 9-7 to 11-5. He was brought here to take us to the playoffs and beyond, and he did not end up doing that. Matt Patricia came in and tried to implement a defense that didn't fit in Detroit. It's too complicated. His players get, you know, miscued. There are 10 players on the field at points, which is unacceptable. Like, Matt Patricia's coaching is not good enough for Detroit. He's not coaching a good enough game plan. He's not coming up with a good enough defensive scheme. He's not good enough for the Detroit Lions right now. And, you know, he knows that. He knows that he's not doing enough because he says at every press conference, we got to coach better. But, you know, saying that and actually doing it are two very different things. And Matt Patricia so far has been a huge disappointment. He has been probably one of the worst coaches in Lions history, which is pretty tough to do, to be honest. I mean, the Lions have had a lot of bad coaches in their years, and Matt Patricia might be one of the worst we've ever had. You know, the record speaks for that. The defensive stats speak for themselves. Like, it's just not good. And, you know, I harp on Matt Patricia a lot. I get on him a lot about his defensive philosophy. I get on him a lot about how his defense keeps giving up these double-digit comebacks. But he is not the only coach in question. You know, Darrell Bevell is, you know, highly suspect when it comes to play calling. He has a couple good plays in the beginning of the game, and then near the middle of the game, it gets very stale, very bland, very predictable. And then near the end of the game, when we need a comeback, you know, I don't know if Matt Stafford's taking over the play calling in the, you know, in the 2-minute drill or what's going on, but all of a sudden in the 2-minute drill in the last 2 minutes of the game, all of a sudden it's productive again, and all of a sudden you just let Matt Stafford cook, and he goes down the field and gets us that game-winning score over and over and over again. We cannot reliably win like that. The Detroit Lions offense cannot do that reliably. You cannot be stagnant for 2.5 quarters, be good the first 2 drives, be stagnant the rest of the game, and then in the last 2 minutes, expect Matt Stafford to come up with some crazy Matthew Stafford magic, and all of a sudden, oh, you're going to go down the field and win a football game. Matt Stafford is a great quarterback. He can absolutely do that if you need him to, but our offense should not have to put him in that situation. Our defense should not have to put Stafford in that situation to make a comeback, to make some amazing throws down the field. A perfect example being that Atlanta Falcons game. You know, our defense should not have to put him in that situation. We should not, as a defense, have to rely on Todd Gurley not knowing where the end zone is just to give Matt Stafford a chance with just over a minute left. Matt Stafford should not be put in that situation. Everybody talks about DeAndre Swift dropping that ball in the first game. DeAndre Swift should not have had to been put in that situation. If the play calling was better throughout the game on both sides of the football, the Lions would not have been in a position to need that comeback. They would not have been in a position to need that Matthew Stafford magic, and they would not have to have been in a situation where, you know, a comeback is necessary. If the offense is just a little more productive, if the defense stops just a couple more drives a game and gets 1 or 2 more turnovers a game, this team can be really, really good. But until they start doing that, until the defense shows up to play, and until the play calling and until the coaching gets better on both sides of the ball, this team has a very, very limited ceiling. And, you know, Corey Ellen's not off the hook either. I like what he's done for a majority of the season, and it's weird. He's kind of the opposite of Darrell Bevell, where I actually like his play calling for a lot of the game, but when it comes to crunch time, when it comes to that last drive, that last 2 drives that the defense needs to make a stand and stand up, the defense, for some reason, does the opposite, and they all of a sudden just, like, collapse, and they forget how they're playing football. Like, I don't understand. It's weird. You know, our offense is a clutch in the final 2 minutes and stagnant the rest of the game. Our defense is pretty solid throughout a majority of the game. And then, like, the second half in the clutch moments, our defense collapses and they just forget what they're doing, I guess. They forget that they play for the Lions and they forget they're trying to win a football game. But, you know, Corey Ellman overall hasn't been bad, but even he has things to work on. And I get it. He's a first-year coach. He has a little bit of an excuse. But Darrell Bevell and Matt Patricia have no excuse at this point. They are second. They are veteran coaches. Matt Patricia is in his third year as a head coach. Darrell Bevell is in his second year of coaching this offense in the Detroit Lions. They have no excuse at this point. They have no excuse to be bad, and they have no excuse, especially, to be as bad as they are. Even with all that, right? Even with the coaching being poor, even with the play calling being poor, I don't necessarily think that that is the biggest reason. That is a huge reason. Don't get me wrong. That is a huge reason to why the Lions are a bad franchise. That is a huge reason to why we have a losing record this season. The play calling was bad and the coaching is poor. But I think the biggest reason and the biggest flaw that this team has is their mentality during a football game. And I briefly talked about this yesterday, but I want to go in depth because this mentality that this Lions team has is the downfall. It is why they are losing football games. It's why these fourth quarter comebacks happen. It's why Matt Patricia and Daryl Bevel look so poor in games. It's why our defense looks bad. It's why our, you know, weapons look bad. It's why our team looks bad in the fourth quarter. And it's why Matt Stafford is put in these situations where he has to be clutch and he has to make a fourth quarter comeback seemingly every single week. If you don't know what I'm talking about when I say the mentality of this team, the Lions have a very don't lose mentality, right? They have this idea that, okay, we're up and we just can't afford to lose. So let's play conservative. Let's back off. Let's be a little bit less aggressive. Nothing gets over the top. We give up everything underneath and we just don't let the big play happen. And eventually the time will run out and eventually we will win. That mindset doesn't work in the NFL. That mindset is not something you can win with in the NFL. The Lions have a don't lose mentality when they should have a win mentality. They should have a winning mentality versus a don't lose mentality. Those two things might sound similar, right? Well, if you're not losing the football game, then how could you, you know, how is that not winning mentality? Well, the Lions, a great example of this, right, would be week one of last season versus the Arizona Cardinals. They were up big. Their defense was working. They were aggressive. They were getting some pressure. They forced a turnover or two, and they were up like 27-3 late in the third quarter, and they got that don't lose mentality. They backed off. They stopped sending pressure. They stopped blitzing a little bit. They dropped more guys into coverage. Those coverage guys gave more cushion on the wide receivers, and that gave Kyler Murray and the weapons all the time in the world they needed to go make a big play. And ironically enough, them backing off, the Lions backing off and giving more cushion and trying not to allow that big play is exactly how big plays happen. Because Kyler Murray gets all the time in the world when we rush three people, and then the wide receivers, even if there are eight people in coverage, find a hole in the zone. They beat their man coverage and they get wide open, and then all of a sudden, you know, we have a busted coverage, or, you know, some guy on the defense just made a wrong step or got beat in his one-on-one situation, and all of a sudden you give up a big play anyways because the quarterback and the wide receivers have all the time in the world to get open on a scramble drill, and they have all the time in the world to get open and make a play. The Lions don't lose mentality is what loses them football games, ironically enough. Like, they back off, they get less aggressive, they give cushions, and that cushion gives the quarterback and the opposing offense all the time they need to pick this defense apart. It doesn't matter if you drop 11 people into coverage. If the quarterback is good enough, if the quarterback is good enough, and generally in the NFL he is, and the offense has all the time in the world to make a play, it doesn't matter if you have 11 Hall of Fame defensive backs back there, eventually somebody will get open if you do not rush anybody. If you do not get any pressure, no matter how many people you drop into coverage, it will never be enough. The Lions mentality is what leads to these fourth quarter comebacks. The Lions mentality of don't lose is what leads to Daryl Bevel's conservative play calling and what leads to us being very predictable and very bland on offense. And obviously that leads to us not being efficient on offense and not scoring enough points. You know, our mentality of don't lose the football game is exactly why we're losing football games. And until that mentality changes, nothing is going to change in Detroit. The ceiling will never get higher. They will never be a true contender. They will never be a true competitor in the NFL until they find a way to break out of this mentality of we're not going to lose. And until they transition from we're not going to lose to we're going to win, we're going to keep our foot on the gas and we're going to go for that kill shot. You know, we're going to go for that knockout punch. Until they develop that, until Matt Patricia develops that instinct, that killer instinct, that ability to swing and hit that knockout punch on an opponent, we will never be a good football team. Until the Lions can develop that ability to get up early, which they have. They have the ability to get up early and score points early in a football game, and they have all the ability to stop the defense or stop the opponent's offense early in football games. They show it every single week that they have the ability to do it, but until they develop that ability to keep their foot on the gas, keep going forward, never get conservative, never worry about don't lose, never worry about the big play. You know, Matt Patricia, I think, outsmarts himself, and part of that is his mentality. He's backing all these guys up, and he's putting so many guys into coverage, but he's disregarding the stuff that has worked throughout the entire game. Matt Patricia doesn't drop eight people into coverage a lot during the game, or during, like, early in the game, and, you know, when he doesn't do that, when he rushes four or five guys, we tend to get pressure and force some mistakes. But when Matt Patricia at the end of games drops eight into coverage, drops nine into coverage, we rush with one or two guys on the field, maybe even three guys on the field at sometimes, you know, it's not good enough. Our players aren't talented enough. Our pass rushers aren't good enough to get home with only three. And giving the quarterback all that time just makes the defensive back's job so much harder. And that's what leads to all these fourth quarter comebacks. And that is the Lions' biggest problem. They do not have a winning mentality in Detroit. They have a don't lose mentality. And the difference between a don't lose mentality and a winning mentality is the difference between 7-9 and 11-5. The difference in those two mentalities is the difference between a average team and a playoff slash Super Bowl contender. You know, the Russell Wilson has that win mentality. Kyler Murray and Tom Brady and Aaron Rodgers, the Packers, the Seahawks, the Ravens, the Chiefs, they all have that winning mentality. They aren't going to take their foot off the gas. They're going to keep putting up points. They're going to keep being aggressive, and they're going to continue to do what works on the field. And until the Lions can figure out how to do that, until the Lions can decide that they want to be like those teams, until the Lions decide they want that winning mentality, until the Lions develop that winning mentality, not just we're not going to lose, but we're going to win and we're going to continue to stay aggressive, until they develop that mentality and that ideology, they're never going to be a true competitor in the NFC. And until, you know, either Matt Patricia develops that, or until we bring in a coach that has that mentality, we will never truly be a competitor in this NFC conference. Now, with all that being said, that is all I got for you guys today. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Have an absolutely fantastic rest of your day. As I said in the beginning, if you are new to the channel and are enjoying the content, please consider liking the videos and subscribing to the channel. It helps me out so much, and it helps the channel out more than you could know. But with all that being said, that is all I got for you guys today. What do you guys think is the biggest problem for this Lions team? Let me know that down in the comments below. But with all that being said, that is all I got for you guys today. If there's Lions news before tomorrow, then I will obviously make a video letting every single person know. But until then, that is all I got for you guys right now. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you all tomorrow with more Lions content. Bye, guys.